this barn and this cabin, and between streams I filled in these two fields right here that looked like on the Project Zomboid map had been already picked. There's some adjustments I do need to make for it though, but I can do those later. That's just to add in, might do it after I do the abandoned cabins. That's to add in haystack or hay bales. Now this one's going to be unique, since the cabins that are here are rather damaged. Some of the cabins are missing part of their roofs, or practically all the roofs. One cabin's missing the roof entirely, and the other is missing part of it. It's hard to figure out exactly what the room I'm working on now would have been. There's not really a door that leads from the rest of the cabin into it, or what might be a door, but it's mostly boarded over. Door right here. But there's no door. It should be easier just to build up the walls and then subtract from them. Change, and that is to change the floor with the spruce, and I'll use Kakia for the roof and ceiling. The roof looks more like Acacia than it does spruce that I was originally going to use. So that's going to make a huge difference. It does look like the roof on this side is damaged, only over here with a good deal of the walls. For damaged boards, I'm just breaking out certain blocks. Okay, it takes care of one of the abandoned cabins. It's a solid fence in Project Zomboid, but I'm just going to use an acacia fence since it's low enough for your character to jump over. Now that you had one piece, she could just simply walk around it. It's a door frame here, but no door. Window frames, but only one window actually has glass in it. That is this one right here. Slightly off, but not by too much. one possibility is this right here. D4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But that's not going to connect. It seems. It's not really a unique wall that I could use. There's these two walls right here, but they're stone. To make these systems a little bit taller than what they should. They are in the Project Zomboid. That's option one for that. Could use a slab on the top like I'm using now. I think that might be the slightly better option. Still looks a slight bit odd, but still works, I think. Basically placing in the dirt patterns in around the abandoned. the abandoned cabins. A small thing, but it'll add to it the atmosphere of the place. And this line right here is simply to make sure I got the abandoned cabins in the right position. It's hard to get damaged boards in right in Minecraft. Not without it looking slightly strange. So, two cabins, one of them without a roof at all, and one of them with a partially damaged roof. Most of the walls taken out on this side. Something missing. Oh, yeah. Before I move on to the rail station, there is one thing I wanted to upgrade on the farm. This right here is going to be filled in. I'll just fill it in off stream. I've been using gray wool carpet to represent driveways and roads. But this is, I believe, one of the last roads outside of the rail station to be filled in. And this road leads to the main highway. And I'll go there temporarily. While I'm going there, I'll just put in this curb. This area in front of me is going to be filled in with trees. I just hadn't done it yet. Highway running along Muldraugh, although Muldraugh is off in the direction I'm pointing right now. And this is just a side road that leads into the back side of Muldraugh. It leads by the farm I was just working on. Also, off stream, I've completed placing in this field right here. In Project Zomboid, it's supposed to be a cornfield, but that's not really an option, so in this case, it is a wheat field. Complete with a scarecrow. The scarecrow's not in the game, it's just an add-on for this particular map. And this one just uses some of the chainmail armor, which happens to look like a biker suit. A mixture of chainmail and leather. The leather cap looks like sunglasses. And this is just on the city texture pack. There is another pile over here that I need to place in. T to create the sections that look like it's hay on the ground, it's like hay spread around everywhere. I just aim downward, and that'll create this type of block. And to do it like it looks in the game itself, where there are bundles of hay, then just aim towards the side of a block, and then you'll get a different type of block. Many of them are like this. The log blocks also operate in a similar fashion. One too far. And I need to find pods all again. Takes care of that section. This one has a similar setup. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Actually, this is one thing that might actually help in Minecraft, since it looks like this is a pretty good place for parkouring and climbing, where it's not really meant for that in Project Zomboid. Okay, so that completes the hay parts of the farm that I forgot to do. And this farm is now done. The trees aren't in just yet. Might do a tree line to show how it's roughly supposed to look. I'll just do the spruce as a tree line. Now, trees aren't going to be exactly like Project Zomboid. There's no way I can get them with that type of precision. So I'm just shooting for something that sort of respects what's there. Usually how I handle it is I just go in first and try to fill in an area with spruce trees. Try to get them a decent amount of distance apart from one another. And I'll come in afterwards and fill in birch and oak trees, depending upon how the spruce trees turn out. see, a little bit too close. It's also in the wrong position. There is a slight path that leads from around here. So I need to sort of be a little bit subtle in this and sort of leave a path like here between the two, between the spruce trees. Some of these trees here are way too close. The trees aren't going to generate in. Spruce trees tend to be a bit finicky, which is why I tend to try to put them in first. If you put them too close to each other, then they may take much longer to generate in. And sometimes they may not generate in at all. Now there is a path from around here that leads to the main road, and hopefully I have the some of the things in the right positions, maybe off by a little bit, but this one right here is fairly straightforward. And I'm not off by too much. It's susceptible. This is where the path right here sort of leads through the backwoods to the farm. And it's off by one or two blocks, but not much. No more than four blocks. Which is pretty good, given the distances that I'm working with. There's a pond over here I've placed in. And this one was a bit harder to do than this because of the nature of the game. It's hard to figure out what parts of it are supposed to be deep and what parts aren't. Since in Project Zomboid, water's water. And what I mean that by that is you're not really going to be getting into it. But in Minecraft, you can. So that requires a little bit of a modification there, but it's not really a huge thing. It And one of the reasons why I'm forcing my character to move faster is so I have less control over how I place the trees in. It's going to feel a little bit manufactured as it is, but I want to cut down on that as much as possible. An open field behind these abandoned cabins. Fairly big. They're not a good place to stay at, but it means that there's a way to spot opponents coming from this side. There wasn't any gardens in the Project Zomboid building right here. I just added them in. Since the field in the Project Zomboid game at this farm is plowed but nothing planted. So it's just ready to accept something being planted there. But here I just went ahead and placed in the plants. There's also a path here, but it's a little bit hard to do the path where I'm limited on the type of grass that I have. So I'm going to just leave this a good walking place between these trees. The good thing about these dirt paths is that you can jump on them, and unlike a plowed field, you're not destroyed by that. And just being in this area is enough for these trees to grow in. But if I move too far away, then the trees won't be able to generate in. This is one of the harder ones that's going to be able to do, because there's also a path along, well, there's a path through the forest around here, and it runs parallel with this highway. So what I'm just going to do is just map out a basic one that eventually leads to the highway way over here. And there is a similar path way over here. And this is going to be the really hard part. Because this path leads up to the back of the farm. Because the distances, this could be just off by a bit. And how everything sometimes gets warped over large distances. And I'll use this as a guide to where I'm roughly aiming towards. Some of these will just seem to vanish. It's easier to see them in Project Zomboid, and that is simply because it's a top-down view on Project Zomboid. But they'll be there. Okay, some of the trees are in. So this will give a decent, I think, will help some of these trees along this path right here. and that might make more visible what I'm talking about, where some of this stuff will sort of vanish. The path isn't going to be completely this big, but you can see how it works. With the trees providing the edge of the path. And I'll place in some spruce, not some spruce, but some birch and some oak trees, and that'll complete it. The path becomes more subtle in this Minecraft build. In some ways it becomes more blatant. As you can see, the subtle part is where the trees are. You can't really see the entire path at one time. All you can do is follow along this ridge right here, where there aren't trees. As I put in more trees, the path will be more defined, but it's still quite a bit different than actually viewing it from top down. And as the trees go in, you get a more complete picture of how this place is. Not all of them are in yet, and when I stream again, I'll stream exactly how it is. Let's see what time it is. We'll take a break for food, but when I stream Project Zomboid again, I'll show this area and how the trees have grown in since I've streamed, and it'll look quite a bit different, but this gives a good indication how it will look, at least. So thank you for watching, and that is it for now.